am Tasneem. I'll be taking your science. Fine. All of you have completed your first chapter. What was the name of your first chapter? It was adaptation in plants. Okay. Now make sure you people have a notebook and a pen with you. Clear? Take a notebook and a pen with you. Fine. So today we'll start our next chapter. That is the food factory of plants. Our next chapter is the food factory of plants. What do you mean by factory? What do you mean by a factory? Factory is a place where things are made. So what do you mean by food factory? Food factory means a place where food is made. So food factory of plants is the part of the plant which makes food for the plant. Okay? So now I'll move ahead. As you all know, we all people need food. All living things need food. So what do you mean by living things? Living things? Sorry, there was some problem in network. We'll start again with which is our next chapter, that is food factory of the plants. What is the food factory of the plants? Food factory of the plant means the part of the plant that makes food for the plant. And which part of the plant makes that food? Green leaves. Green leaves of a plant makes food for the plant. Okay, now we'll all living things need food to grow. Okay? We all are living things. We all need food to grow, to carry out daily life activities. Now, what do you mean by daily life activities? Daily life activities like running, playing, studying. For all of these, you need energy. And where do you get this energy from? You get this energy from food. Do you have a copy and pen? Do you have a copy and pen? Okay? Just write some words. Some living things can make their own food, while some depend on others for their food. Clear? Some living things can prepare their own food, while others have to depend on other organisms for obtaining their food. Living things that can produce their own food are known as autotrophs. See here, just note this word. Autotrophs. It is A-U-T-O-T-R-O-P-H-S. Autotrophs. Here, A-U-T-O-T-R-O-P-H-S. It is autotrophs. What are autotrophs? Autotrophs are living things that can make their own food. See, auto, how will you remember? See, auto means self. Self means apne aap, khud se. Trophos means to feed or to obtain food. Okay, organisms that can make their own food are autotrophs. Examples of autotrophs are green plants. Okay, examples of autotrophs are green plants. Write it down. Just write keyword autotrophs, then write example green plants. Clear? Now, another type of organism that cannot make their food. Okay, living organisms that cannot make their food are known as heterotrophs because they have to depend on other plants for their food. Clear? See, living organisms that depend on other plants, others for food are known as heterotrophs. See, again, H-E-T-E-R-T-R-O-P-H-S. Okay, write it down. H-E-T-E-R-T-R-O, heterotrophs. It should be O here. H-E-T-E-R-O-T-R-O-P-H-S, heterotrophs. There is a O in between R and T also. Clear? Okay. Hetero means others. And trophos means to feed. That means living organisms that depend on others for food are known as heterotrophs. Examples are animals and human beings. See, we human beings and other animals cannot make their own food. We have to depend on plants. We eat certain plants. Or some animal products or animals. That too, in that case also, we directly or indirectly depend on plants. We obtain our food from plants. So we are heterotrophs. Clear? Written? Autotrophs and heterotrophs? Now, as I have told you, okay, food factory of plants is green leaves of the plants. Just don't write leaves. Right, green leaves. Green is very important there. Okay, only green leaves can make food for the plants. Not all. Clear? Clear? Fine. So we'll see now different parts of a leaf. Check here. As leaves are food factories of the plants, we will study in detail the structure of leaf. See, now note this points down. Different parts of a leaf are leaf blade or leaf lamina, it is also known as. Second is leaf apex. The tip of the leaf, the pointed part of the leaf is known as leaf apex. Okay, leaf margin, the boundary of leaf. See here, this boundary or edge of the leaf is known as leaf margin. Clear? Now, main vein or midrib. Can you see a thin tube running through the middle of the leaf? This one, this tube in the middle one. This is the main vein or midrib. Okay, now can you see smaller tubes attached to the main vein or the midrib, the middle one? This smaller tubes, this one and this one. And this one, and this one, these are side veins. Okay, what are these? Side veins. Now see this, stalk of the leaf. Stalk of the leaf with which it is attached to the plant. It is known as petiole. P-E-T-I-O-L-E, petiole. Okay, petiole. Clear? Fine. And now next is stomata. Stomata. We will find out what it is. Okay. First, we'll define all the parts of the leaf. See. What is leaf blade? See. The flat part of the leaf. See flat part. This flat whole part of the leaf is known as leaf blade. Another name of leaf blade is lamina. Okay, another name of leaf blade is lamina. Now, tip of the leaf. What is the tip of the leaf called? See, the tip of the leaf or the pointed part here, it is known as leaf apex. Okay, it is known as leaf apex. Here, the thin tube that runs through the middle of the leaf. See, this thin tube, I have shown you, this thin tube that runs through the middle of the leaf. This is known as midrib or main vein. Okay, you can draw this leaf in your notebook. Fine? Okay, and if you have any doubts, you can type in the chat box. Do you know where the chat box is? You know now? Okay, or you can take the help of your parents. Fine, you know how to type? So any doubts you can type it there. See, now what is Midrib, the thin tube that passes through the middle of the leaf is known as midrib, or another name of midrib is, see, this is midrib, another name is main vein. Clear? Now, small tubes that are attached to midrib, see small tubes here. Can you see these small tubes? Here it is, here it is, here it is, and this one, can you see them? These are side veins. What are they called? Side veins. Clear? Fine. Have you written all the parts? Written all the parts? I will give you 2 more minutes to write it down. Write down all the parts. Leaf blade or lamina. It is the leaf apex. The leaf margin is the boundary of the leaf or edge of the leaf. This one. Then main vein or the midrib, the middle one. Side veins are the small tubes here. Then petiole is the stalk of the leaf. Okay. And stomata, we will find out where it is present. These are the definitions of all parts of leaves. Clear? Shall we move ahead? Done? Kashvi, written? Show me a thumbs up. Written? Dash, written? Good. Shall we move ahead then? Okay. Now, leaf showing stomata. In the parts of leaf, you have written stomata also. Now, what do you mean by stomata? Stomata are tiny pores. Pores means small openings. Holes. Openings. Clear? Do you know what do you mean by pores? They are small pores on the underside of leaf. Now, what do you mean by underside? Leaves have two sides. Upper part and lower part. Okay? Underside of leaf means the lower side of the leaf. Okay? See, upper side of the leaves are shiny and smooth. While the lower sides of leaves are dull and rough. I'll show you. Okay? After this. First, where are stomata present? Stomata are present on the underside of a leaf. Where are they present? They are present on the underside of a leaf. And see the structure of stomata. They are the small pores, tiny pores. We cannot see them. They are very minute. They are microscopic. Clear? See. This is stomata. This opening, this black one, this pore. This is stomata. These are the cells around stomata. Okay? Clear this one? Clear the structure of stomata? See, this is the structure of stomata. Okay? This is the structure of stomata. Fine? And what are stomata? Stomata are tiny pores present on the underside of a leaf. Clear? Now, functions of midrib and side veins. Okay? What is midrib? Okay? What do you mean by midrib? I have shown you what is midrib. See, I'll show you again. See, this is midrib. The middle tube. Okay? And these are side veins. Okay? So, what are they used for in, what is the use of midribs and side veins in a leaf? Midribs and side veins help in transporting water, minerals and food. Clear? What makes food for the plant? Leaves make food for the plant. Okay? The food prepared by the leaves should go to other parts of the plant also. Okay? So, how do it go? How does it go? It goes through midrib and side veins. Okay? Now, plants also need water and minerals. Where do plants get water and minerals from? Okay. Plants get water and minerals from soil. It is absorbed by the roots of the plants. Okay? And this water and minerals should also reach the leaves. So, midrib and side veins helps in transporting water, minerals and food in plants. Clear? Now, next point is, Midrib, they also provide strength to the leaf blade. What is the leaf blade? What do you mean by leaf blade? Leaf blade is the flat part of the leaf. Okay? This network of tubes provide strength to the leaf blade and give it a proper shape. Okay? Clear? Now, functions of stomata. What are the different functions of stomata? See, stomata are tiny pores that are present on underside of leaves. See, these are stomata. So, what are the functions of stomata in plants? See, stomata, as they are pores, openings, so gases can enter through it. Okay, plants can prepare their own food. They are autotrophs. So, during photosynthesis will find out in detail what does it mean. Okay, during photosynthesis, it is the process by which plants make their food. Photosynthesis is the process by which plants get their food. Next class we'll study in detail what photosynthesis is. Okay, during photosynthesis, carbon dioxide enters the leaf through stomata and oxygen is given out. And during respiration, what respiration is? As we breathe, we all breathe, we take in oxygen and we give out carbon dioxide. Okay? So during respiration, plants also breathe. Plants also breathe. They take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. This oxygen enters into the plant through stomata and carbon dioxide is given out. Clear? Note these 2 points. Importance of or the functions of stomata in plants. Okay? Now, here are few question and answers. If you have any doubts, bachcha, you can write in chat box. You can type it there. Okay? In last 10 minutes, we will discuss the doubts. Fine? Now, first question is, why do we need food? Why do we need food? We need food to grow, to get energy, to carry out daily life activities. Okay? And for carrying out daily life activities, we need energy. And for energy, we have to take in food. Okay? Clear? All living things grow and all living things need food, and that differentiate them from non-living objects. Now, what are autotrophs? What are autotrophs? Living things that can make their own food are called autotrophs. Okay? Example of autotrophs, green plants. Only green plants can make their own food. Now, what are heterotrophs? Living things that depend on others for food are known as heterotrophs. Hetero means others. Okay, as I have told earlier, hetero means others. They depend on others for food. Auto means self. They can prepare their food by their own. Examples of heterotrophs are animals and human beings. Okay, now name the different parts of a leaf. Different parts of a leaf are leaf blade, leaf apex, midrib, side veins, stomata, leaf margin, and petiole. Okay? Fine? These are the different parts of a leaf. What is petiole? Stalk of the leaf. Where are the stomata present on the leaf? Where are the stomata present on leaf? Stomata are present on the underside of the leaf, lower surface of the leaf. Okay, I'll show you. Okay, just we'll see in the chat box if you have any doubts. Tanvi, what do you mean by first one? What you can't write, bachcha? Water pores, agam, water pores. Pores means they are the small openings. Openings. I'll show you. Check here. See. I'll again Have you seen a sponge? Have you seen a sponge? It has minute pores in that. Okay, it is porous. It has minute pores. These are pores. Okay. See, these are pores. They are openings. Through this, carbon dioxide may enter and oxygen comes out. Gases may enter and leave through this stomata. Okay. Tanvi, I can't understand which first one you can't write. You haven't written. And no issues. I'll be uploading this PDF on Schoolroom also. Fine? Okay. Any other doubts you people have? Any other doubts you people have? Okay. Any more doubts? Clear? Who has raised hands? Please let me know if you have any doubts. Let me check. What is respiration? We breathe. We all breathe. We take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. This is a part of respiration. You will learn this in higher classes. Means taking in of oxygen and giving out of carbon dioxide is a part of respiration. It is respiration includes breathing also. Function means uses. What does it do? Functions of what you haven't written. No issues, bacha. Agar, I'll be uploading this. You can write it from there. I just wanted you to write the keywords so that you become familiar with it. Second function of stomata. Second function of stomata. It is respiration, bacha. It is breathing. As we breathe, plants also breathe. They also need oxygen. Okay? No issues if you haven't written anything. Just I wanted you to write the keywords. Okay? So that you become familiar with that word, with those words. Okay? Okay? Fine. Clear? See, I'll again will come to question answers part. Okay? Why do we need food? We need food to grow, to get energy and to carry out daily life activities. Autotrophs can prepare their own food. For example, green plants and heterotrophs cannot. Okay, they depend on others. Okay, now different parts of leaves are leaf blade, leaf apex, midrib, side veins and stomata. And where are the stomata present on leaf? They are present on the underside of a leaf. Now see, check this. Now, this is for you. You will have to do this. Okay? Label the different parts of a leaf. This is your assignment. Fine? This part, this is your assignment. What is 1? What is 2? What is 3? What is 4? What is 5? And what is 6? We have right now studied all these 6 parts of a leaf. Okay, you should know what are they. Clear? Fine? Okay? Do it yourself. I'll be uploading this. Just write it down yourself what are the different parts of the leaf. Here, this part. Okay? Yes. Okay, and students, join the meeting with your names. Okay, I don't want to see this Vivo 1661 or don't join with the name of your device. Okay, fine. Now I'm stopping the share. Okay, and I will show you a leaf. Check it out. Can you all see me now? Am I visible to you all? Okay, see, I have a leaf here. Can you see this leaf? Can you all see this leaf? I will show you the parts of the leaf. See, this stalk of the leaf, this is known as petiole. With the help of this stalk, the leaf is attached to the plant. Okay, see, the tip of the leaf, this tip, can you see the pointed tip? This is known as leaf apex. What is this called? Leaf apex. See this now. This edge of the leaf. See, it is zigzag. Some leaves have rough edge and some have smooth. And this edge of the leaf is known as leaf margin. What is this called? Leaf margin. Clear? And this flat part, this flat part of the leaf is known as lamina or leaf blade. What is this? What is it called? Lamina or leaf blade. Okay? Clear? And see, this middle line, can you see the middle line? See, from petiole it arises. The middle line, a middle tube. This is known as midrib or the main vein. See this one. This one. Okay? This is the midrib or main vein. Now, the side tubes, can you see? Which are attached to the midvein? This one, this one. These are known as side veins. What are they called? Side veins. Okay? Samadeep, clear? Arav, Athar. Okay, can you see the leaf, bacha? Kavya, can you see the leaf? All parts are clear now? This is petiole. This is leaf margin. This is leaf apex. Okay. This is midrib. And these are side veins. Now I have told stomata are present on the underside of leaf. So what do you mean by underside? See, this is the upper side of the leaf and this is the underside. Here, see, upper side is bright in color. Okay. And smooth. And underside is dull. Okay, stomata are present here. They are very minute. We cannot see it with our eyes. We will have to use microscope for seeing stomata. Okay, see, stomata are present on the underside of the leaf. Clear? Somet, Tanvi, Zainab, can you see the underside of the leaf? See two sides, upper and lower. This lower side is known as the underside of the leaf. And stomata are present here. Okay? Clear? Yajat, Abhijay, Adhya, clear? All the parts of the leaf. Clear, bacha? Clear to everyone? Clear? Great. Very nice. So you'll see the chat box again if you have any doubts. Please revise the part. We have done it, bacha, so many times now. Clear now? I've shown you the leaf also. All the parts are clear. This is petiole. The middle tube is midvein. Margin. Leaf apex. The flat part is leaf lamina and side veins. And stomata are present here. They are very minute. We cannot see them. Okay, see, this is leaf blade. This is leaf blade. Clear? Fine. All the parts of leaf are clear now. Okay. So we'll continue with the chapter in our next class. Any other doubts? We'll continue with the chapter in our next class and we'll see how these leaves help in producing food for the plants. Okay. We will find out what is the process of making food by the plants in detail. Okay, that's all for today. We'll see you soon again. Bye. Take care. Okay. Great. Okay. Good. Revise and note down all the points.